Here I am going to conduct general bearing experiment in design laboratory. What is bearing? It is a rotating, it is a stationary element which supports rotating elements. Now coming on to the general bearing. In this experiment we are going to determine what is the pressure distribution across the general and the bearing. Yes. Now coming on to the observation in this experiment, the diameter of the general is 50 mm and the inside diameter of the bearing is 55 mm. Bearing length is 100 mm and the speed of the bearing will be noted down while doing the experiment. Later on, the lubricating oil uses SAE40. SAE is Society of Automotive Engineers and for their reference, what is the viscosity of the fluid fields. Next, coming on to the theory of the general bearing, it runs on the principle of hydrodynamic theory of lubrication. Next, moving on to the tabular column. The general bearing is attached with 12 connections in a radial direction. In radially, there are 12 tubes which are at 30 degree space each apart, and the fluid will be entered inside the bearing. Later on, the initial pressure end, before switching on the experiment, will note down what is the initial pressure. After stabilization, that is after general coming at certain position, we are going to note down what is the final reading in all the 12 tubes. Next, we will take what is the difference between the initial pressure and the final pressure. That will be the difference in pressure. For this calculation, we will plot a graph and we will see where the maximum pressure is acting on the general bearing in the experimental setup. Here you can see there are 16 tubes. From tube 1 to 12, it exhibits the radial pressure on the general bearing. Next, from tube A to D, it exhibits the axial pressure which will be neglected. And hence, the pressure reading from tube 1 to tube 12 will be considered. And here we can observe the general and the bearing setup. There are 12 connections which are attached circumferentially in order to measure what is the radial pressure. And A to D will be neglected since it is axial pressure. And what is the speed of the general? We can note it down here. The initial pressure we can observe here is 82.7. Since the general and bearing are stationary, it is not rotating. The initial pressure is 82.7 in all tubes. Next, we have to start the experiment. And we will allow it to rotate around from a speed 150 rpm to 180 rpm, and we can observe here there is a pressure exerted on the general and hence the fluid level is increasing. We have to allow this experiment to run for some certain time period. Later on we will measure what is the readings in tube 1 to tube 12. After stabilization of the general, we are going to type the final pressure of all the 12 tubes as shown in the tabular column. Later on, we take the difference between the final and initial pressure head, and that difference also will be tabulated. After getting all the values, that is the difference from initial and final of tube 1 to 12, we are going to plot a graph. By taking the diameter of the general, that is 50 mm, from that we are going to divide the circle into 12 equal parts, equally spaced, that is 30 degree each. Later on we shot 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, all the 12 tubes, and from the surface of the general we are going to plot the difference in values. We will get this issue. The negative values will be inside and the positive values will be outside from the reference of the general. The maximum